Hi, my name is Ndidi Obioha. 10 years ago, I was in the banking industry, but today I run a very successful event management company known as Enthys Event Consulting Company. People often ask me how I make it seem so easy, effortless, and flawlessly put together. I'm talking about the events that I do. But the truth is, it is not. It comes with a lot of pressure, tension, madness.
It is about the success of the event.
But I've got the best team on ground, and I was built for this. It's a very demanding career for a wife and a mother of three. But in all of this, I love what I do. Welcome to my world, our world. We are the Event Bros. You're welcome to another episode of the Event Bros. Now, on this particular edition, we will be looking at the amazing traditional wedding that we put together for this couple that are from two different parts of the world, what we call a culture mix. The groom is from Anambra in Nigeria, and then the bride is from the Dominican Republic. Beautiful bride. It was an amazing experience. We're going to be bringing you the behind the scenes and the amazing experience we have putting this together. Welcome to my world, our world. We are the Event Bros. Consultants, there are no particular ways these jobs come. Sometimes our jobs come from referrals where clients, prospective clients, have seen some jobs that we've done and we say to themselves, okay, this planner is the person I want to use when I want to do my event. And that's exactly what happened in this case. The groom's mom, Mrs. Chinwen Gonadi, had actually been to a few weddings that we had done. And I remember her saying to me then, when my son is ready to get my degree, I'm definitely going to call on you. And I was so elated when she actually did fulfill that.
My name is Mrs. Chinwen Gonadi, Big Chi. I am the vehicle through which he was transported into this world. Prior to this period, I wouldn't have taken anybody as a wedding planner or event planner. Because I would believe in myself that I could do it. You know, maybe me, my friend Pamela Aribe, we just put hands together and we'll get it done. But when Ngozi called me, I said, "Mommy, who is your wedding planner?" I said, "I don't have any." He said, "No, Didi will call you." I said, "Which Didi?" He said, "Didi." I said, "Oh my God, you've caught me. Not Didi. I love her."
And she said, "I would like for you to handle the traditional wedding. It's going to be happening in June." And I think this call came through sometime in February. And we set to motion. We had a couple of meetings to understand what the groom's mom wanted. Lovely venue.
Beautiful.
Very
beautiful
nice.
Place.
Fabulous.
Wow. Okay.
Clean.
Mm. Wow.
Fantastic.
Wow, straight to the point.
Mm. Okay. So, Antioke, so this is it for the traditional wedding.
Yeah.
That's what you're looking at. Okay, like we spoke about the phone.
Yeah.
Okay. Talk about how many pieces, how many people can this place take? How many can we fit in here?
Theater style, we can fit 1,000, 1,001.
Okay.
Banquet style, 850.
850 banquet style. Yeah. Mm. Okay. Considering that we're gonna have the couples area, dance area, band area.
Yeah, you don't have the
stage. Okay, you have your stage. Okay. Anyway, at some point we'll just do a recce and do front and all that. Okay. I like the flooring though.
It's
clean
fantastic.
And very nice.
Okay.
Exquisite. Okay, fantastic. But actually, what crowd size are you looking at? What are you expecting?
Quite a large crowd.
Quite a large crowd.
Yeah.
Not like large.
Many.
At least 800.
And if any can take this, cheesy.
I'm not raising to the point to.
And I mean, but for me, for a venue that can take 850 people, I usually would play, say, at that point and say 700. Okay. Do you understand? Mm-hmm. Considering all the other things that would be, that would come into the venue. Exactly, yeah.
If you can put about 70 tables.
If you can fit 70 tables, that's fine by you.
So that people can be passing around.
Okay, okay.
I don't want anything tight.
70 tables, okay.
70 tables. We have
that takes about 10 chairs.
There'll be room for more, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Each table 10.
70. That's 700.
By 10, that's 700 people. Yeah, exactly. So we cannot, any which way, we cannot plan for more than 700. Okay, but actually, you know, you're a very popular person.
In planning traditional weddings, even in Nigeria, the cultures differ. The way it is done from this particular ethnic group is not the same way it's done in another ethnic group. So we usually try to understand what's peculiar to each ethnic group that we're trying to put together weddings from that end.
It's an Igbo traditional wedding.
Yes.
So we would definitely have, because usually the Igbos usually have it in the village, but this is us bringing all of that to town. So certain elements of the traditional wedding will still have to be covered any which way, whether it's in the east or it's here in town, and all that. And then, so then we definitely want to know from you some of those elements that are peculiar to your own culture. Like, I mean, you know how usually we have the couches where the parents themselves will sit and all that. Are you looking to do the whole bride price and all that there, or all that has been done? This is just going to be the reception,
the engagement.
So this is just more like the reception of the traditional wedding.
The reception to let people know that he is married.
Yes.
They are married.
Okay.
It's interesting to note that the Dominican Republic is actually the second largest Caribbean country after Cuba, which means that they have such rich culture. I mean, I remember the bride saying to me, our culture is pretty similar to the Nigerian culture. And what I liked most about this wedding was we're going to be showing the Dominicans how it is done in the Nigerian sense of it. The interesting thing about the Igbo culture is that if it's an Igbo groom that's getting married to an Igbo bride, we would ordinarily do what the Igbo bride culture would expect, not the groom's end. But in this case, it was the reverse. The bride was made to bring the bride into our own culture to show her how we do our own things. And that I found very interesting and exciting. So that's what, how many cooling tests are you coming with?
It's many. I'm coming with 15
Okay.
Because you know, I normally chill them before I will not put them in the tent.
In the tent.
It's already chilled. No, it's going to be chilled in the morning. It's just 10 minutes. Because it's there's small ice. No, it's not cooling down. Don't worry. Trust me, please.
What is that? What I do?
All my drinks are dead. You know, when I say I take cognizance of that it has to be chilled to the end of the event.
From start to finish, so assorted.
Because the money you pay me, you have to save when you touch it.
Name is Bola Okoli. I do drinks in parties. I'm actually handling this event, which is a wedding for like about 1,000 people. And I'm working closely with Entis. We're doing the event together. They are the event planners, and I'm the one handling the drinks. This particular event is going to be awesome, and it's going to be very nice because the kind of people the event planner I'm working with is one of the is one of the best in the industry. So I look forward to work with them, and I'm very sure it's going to be smooth.
Richard, where do we stand on this invitation distribution? Because as I did yesterday, two of us are working with the Korean companies. I want to know where we stand right now.
Actually, the Korean people came to pick up some invites like 2 days ago, and they sent some list of items named the dispatch already. But I was not impressed with it.
I'd like to see my list. I need to know where we stand.
That's what I've missed the more since.
No, but Richard, you can't tell me that of all the list of names that we have, on that list, this is what we have out.
I was knowing
you. Richard, this is not working. This is not working. You know, madam will freak out when she sees this list.
No, I'll put a problem to you, madam.
You need to put more pressure, and we need to know what we stand as if. As an end of business today, I need to get a full list of what has been delivered. We're going to have comes in there and soon start questioning us.
I mean, I remember losing it with my staff when I realized that the distribution of the meditation cards were not going as fast as my client had called me and was like, Didi, what is going on? And we had, you know, contracted this out to a vendor, a courier company, and they just kind of like sat on it. I totally lost it with my staff because I'm like, this is 3 weeks to the wedding, people haven't gotten their invitations. What is going on? I'm hearing from the client that even her guests in Lekki here haven't received their invitation cards. The ones in Ikoyi, I mean, if you're saying to me the ones in Abuja and outside Lagos, I understand, but for crying out loud, how can we be having issues with the ones here in Lagos? Richard, what is going on?
Everything to the courier people to deliver, so we don't know why they are taking so long.
If somebody is following up on them, then you will understand what the issues are.
I followed up on them yesterday. That's why they had to give me this list. So
How many invitation cards were given to the courier company?
We gave them like 150.
And the ones that you gave to them, where, at what addresses, which areas are they?
Basically in Lagos and
in Lagos, Island, and they haven't been delivered till now. This is. You know, this is totally unacceptable, Richard. This is unacceptable. And this is what's going to happen now. All the ones in Lekki, Ikoyi, VI, I don't care how you guys want to do it. Drop everything you're doing right now and make sure that those invitation cards are delivered. 48 hours, what I'm giving you guys. I want all those cards out to this guest. I would not have this. A day to the event. Oh. I remember the decorator arriving. He has come all the way from Enugu. Now, why did I have to pick a decorator with all the decorators that we have in Lagos? But Kachi had done a few jobs for me in the East, and I liked his translation or his interpretation of what an ethnic event should look like, especially from the Igbo-speaking part of the country. And so I did convince my client to have us use him. And yes, he did definitely show me that it was a decision well taken because he came through. It was beautiful. He had the ethnic fabrics that, you know, showed that, yeah, it was a traditional wedding. we had the bamboos, like I said, and all of that, the different, it was just a touch of it, and he did interpret it the way we wanted. My client was very happy. But I remember when my client, the daughter, Ngozi Nkoji, came to the venue the night before we were setting up, and she saw the couple's area. She said to me, Didi, I love the look of this stage, but why are we confining the couple? Why do we have this frame that they have to bring, that they have to be in, looking like we're boxing them in? So she had a bit of a problem with that, and I kind of agreed with her. So we had to take that down. And God, I felt so sorry for the decorator, because they had been working on this all day. And finally, at night, we had to take that bit out. But when we took it out, the difference was clear. It looked more spacious, and, you know, it kind of gave it a nicer feel and look of a bigger stage area, which works. D-Day finally did come, and luckily for us, because we started the night before, it was just trying to touch up stuff. The vendors also all arrived the day before. The caterers had all done their whole setup, and in the morning everybody was just putting finishing touches to what they had to do, because the event started about 1 p.m. So I wanted my venue definitely ready 4 hours to the event. I had to get my team to do the research on, you know, what is expected from the culture, the groom's culture. And I do remember when we were brainstorming, we talked about getting cultural dancers. The idea of getting the cultural dancers from Nigeria is especially the dancers that would interpret the Igbo style of dancing, was to entertain our guests from the Dominican Republic, the bride's family and all that. We had the groom coming with the male dancers, and in the Igbo culture, there's this, the flutist. You know, they have this way of coming in and welcoming or letting you know that they're announcing their arrival. Now, this was them announcing the arrival of the prince, which, of course, for us is the groom and all that. So they had that with his friends behind him and the dancers. So that was very interesting and exciting. We also did the same for the bride. We got the bride. I remember saying to the bride, when they came into the country, which is just a few days to the wedding, we had actually set up a meet. The idea was to get the bride to learn some of our dance styles from the Igbo end. And she was very excited. In fact, that was one bride that I'd seen that was ready to go all out to embrace the Nigerian culture, the Igbo culture in particular. And that was, it was just fantastic.
Have you seen my beautiful baby? Have you seen my tomato baby? Oh, ELA, baby, suffering the cool me temper. Ada, baby, na sugar, sugar. Yo. Hey, hey, hey. Everybody, they wait. Put a can and no more. If I did my maca, better soup on a money kill a mo. Ada, mwa, pekem, ya, ada.
The dancers to come up with a song that I can really dance to, because Dominicans, we love to dance, we love to shake. And I was like, oh wow, that's interesting. And you know, so we tried to come up with all that, and she was on that day, she was just beautiful. She danced herself in with the dancers that ushered her in. And you know, the Dominicans were very excited seeing what the Igbo culture is like, seeing the rich dance styles from that end. It was just beautiful.
Wow.
Now, interpreting the culture, the Igbo culture, the way it's done in the Igbo custom, the good thing was the typical engagement had been done, which is the paying of the dowry and all that had been taken care of way before this day. So what we actually tried to do on the day of this wedding, the traditional wedding, was actually the reception part of it, of the, you know, the traditional wedding itself, which is just the reception aspect of it. And in doing that, the main thing we had to showcase from the Igbo culture as to how traditional weddings are done is where the bride has to find her husband. Now, the bride comes in the very first time with her friends, and they just come in to greet the guests and the in-laws to be and all that. It's just a greeting entrance. And right after that, she goes back to change. And once she's changed, she comes in the second time. This time around is to find her groom. So she usually would go, the groom's father gives the drink, the palm wine. This is remembering that these are dead Dominicans. The bride is from the Dominican Republic. So he had to take the palm wine. Palm wine is a significant drink that must be present at every Igbo traditional wedding. It's mandatory. And what this symbolizes is that this is the person that she has accepted as her husband.
You put money inside. You want to put money inside. Yeah.
Bride looked amazing. The groom danced his heart out. I remember the mom talking to her and say, Didi, look at my son dancing Shukito Igbo song. And it was so funny. But we had an amazing time. And we're glad that at the end of the day, my client was truly satisfied. Because that is all that matters to us.
People were asking, who is the event planner? I said, me. Then I now told them, let this.
Slick City Empire.